Morning there. Craig Grabo with Central Lawn Care. Hope you'll take a moment to talk lawn and landscape with me. Today, I'd like to cover watering bare areas. Since we're still in the seeding season and we have reached kind of a dry patch, it kind of reminded me that we need to go ahead and address this type of watering as well as the overseeding watering, which I did earlier. So when we're talking about bare areas and the type of watering that we're going to do in them, we're talking about large bare areas. So kind of think you killed off your entire lawn, right? Because maybe you had some sort of noxious weed or something like that that you needed to get rid of. So you went ahead, you killed it off, and now you're ready to completely reseed it, maybe put down some straw and things like that. Maybe it's not so big. Maybe you're talking about an area that might only be 3x3, but still, that's a pretty big surface area in your lawn that can be approached by the elements in different ways. So those are the areas that I'm discussing. When we want to water those areas. So right now, yes, we have cooler temperatures, but we have no cloud coverage, and we also have no rain in the forecast in the future. So at least for the next 7 days. So say today you are looking at a scenario like that, and you are getting ready to do that seeding work. Well, we got to consider a few things when we're considering our watering. One, we have a large surface area, so it's exposed to the elements. Two, that seed is only going to be living in about the top, let's just call it, eighth to a half inch of that soil for the next 2 to 3 weeks. So that means that it's going to come out, it's going to set its roots. As soon as it's setting its roots, and it's in kind of that eighth inch layer, then all of a sudden it's going to start to grow to that half inch. But that top eighth to half inch layer, that's going to dry out just from wind alone. So even if you have straw down, that's going to protect a little bit. It's going to add a little bit of coverage so that the moisture stays. But when that wind picks up, it can dry out tremendously, especially if we have clear nights, clear days. There's just a lot of evaporation that can happen. So we always recommend, if you're going to have a large bare area, plan, especially if you're doing this in like September, kind of our time of year, where it might not be as moist at times, but it can definitely be very dry, it can be windy and things like that. We're going to say plan to water at minimum 20 to 30 minutes every day for the next 2 to 3 weeks. Now, when watering, you always have to look at your soil. Is it puddling? Is it puddling for longer than a few hours? Is it puddling for 24 hours? If so, you need to dial it back. Is it drying out wicked quick? Because you could be talking about a slight grade, which means that not only is it exposed to the wind and things of that nature, it's also exposed to runoff. So even though you're watering for 20 to 30 minutes, you got to remember that first 5 minutes probably ran off. So always take those things into consideration, evaluate your soil, see what the scenario is giving you, and adjust accordingly. Is it running off too quick and wind's coming along, so it's drying out a lot faster? Go ahead and maybe bump up your times, or maybe bump up your frequency. Maybe you're doing it 2 times a day for 10 minutes instead of 1 time a day for 20 minutes. Or maybe it's 2 times a day for 30 minutes each time. It just all depends on the scenario. So watering is not just set it and forget it. Not every yard is going to be the same. Not every scenario in your yard is going to be the same. So you kind of have to adjust accordingly. I really appreciate you taking a moment to talk lawn and landscape with me. I hope you see some great success this fall, so next spring and summer, you're really enjoying that lawn. Till next time.